Matt Zimmer, Argus Leader. George, what's it like being back at this tournament? Does it feel a little bit different this time being here as a member of the Jackrabbits?
It feels great. Just to be able to, just know that all the hard work and the goal that we set at the beginning of the year, we achieved that goal, and to be here just means a lot.
Elliot Nathan, KSFY Sports. Deondre and George, can you just talk kind of about the seeding process, and at this point, how much is really 12 just a number, and once the ball tips off that aspect, the number behind the team doesn't really matter?
Deondre, let's start with you.
We didn't really care about what seed we have. We was looking forward to getting the tournament and playing against a great team and trying to make a run in a tournament. And I mean, we just look at it as another game, but another great opportunity for this program.
Yeah, we really didn't put too much emphasis on the seed because we know whoever we were playing would be a good team. So, our preparation wasn't any different. And like Deondre said, we're looking at it as another game.
Questions for George, Roman Stubbs with the Washington Post. What have you seen, I guess, in your study of Melo Trimble and Rashid Suleiman? What kind of challenge does Maryland's backcourt present to you guys?
They're really two good guards. They can do a little bit of everything. They can shoot it from the outside. They can also drive, get in the paint and make plays for themselves and other teammates. So, we're really just looking to control those guys and hope that, spirals down for the rest of the team.
Daniel Martin from Comcast Sports in DC for Mike. The matchup coming up against Diamond Stone, both you guys, young guys, and funny enough, both have been brought off the bench at certain times. Just from a matchup perspective, what do you see in Diamond's game, and is this going to be one of the more fun matchups that you've had so far this year?
Yeah, it'll definitely be one of the more fun ones. It'll be a tough matchup. Diamond's a terrific player, and it'll be tough to guard him down low, and I'll just have to make sure I work extra hard on the defensive end, guarding him and just trying to keep him out of the post and make the catches tough for him.
Travis Fossing, Kello TV for Mike Daum. Mike, as a redshirt freshman, how do you adjust to not letting the stage be too big? You made the move from non-conference to conference play, then to the Summit League tournament. It seems like you've made the leap with every step. How do you do that again for the NCAA tournament?
Well, the court stays the same size. The venues just get bigger. So that's something I look at. It's not really a change for me. And I know I have a great leadership with the seniors who keep me calm-headed through the whole thing.
Deondre, what do the guards have to do in this game? I mean, obviously, Maryland's got a lot of size, more than you guys are used to dealing with. What do the guards have to do to help you guys win this game?
We just got to play. I mean, play aggressive, stay focused, and, guard those two guys. And they have to guard us, too. So, I mean, it should be a great, a fun matchup and a great game. And, we just got to come out and play aggressive. And, everybody know who those two are. And we just looking forward to playing those guys.
Mike, Coach Nagy's always put a big emphasis on rebounding and defensive side of the ball. That has to be arguably one of the most critical points today or tomorrow will be controlling the glass and really dominating on that side of it against what will be a very difficult front line for Maryland.
Yeah, that's definitely one thing that we talked about is making them take tough contested shots from the outside, and then what we have to do is rebound. And Coach Nagy talks about gang rebounding, where our guards come down and help us too. And it's going to take all five guys to out rebound this team.
More questions?
George, there have been a lot of 12 seeds to win in the first round. Do you guys get some confidence out of that? Feel like you can be one of those Cinderella teams?
I mean, yeah, definitely. We're not necessarily looking at it as, you know, we're 12 and the 5 and, you know, those upsets always happen, but we know what we're capable of and going into this game. So we're just looking at the game itself and we know what we're capable of doing.
Any more questions? Coach Nagy from South Dakota State is with us. We'll ask Coach to make a brief opening statement and then open it up for questions. Coach?
Well, like everybody else, we are excited to be here. It's you know, it's not brand new to us, but to our group, it's pretty brand new. We only have one player that has played in an NCAA tournament. But we have a pretty experienced team. We count on seniors a lot, and we count on one freshman quite a bit. But we have a lot of confidence, and I think that our players are excited about playing. It's nice. Most of the year we've been carrying the pressure in terms of what's expected of us in our league, and it's going to be nice to not be expected to win the basketball game. I think our kids will play loose.
Questions for Coach?
Hey, Scott. Daniel Martin from CSN in Washington, D.C. Coach Turgeon had a lot of praise for what Mike does well, his counterpart on the other side, Diamond, another young guy, another freshman. What have you seen that he does well in his game? What do you have to do to limit him?
Well, the first thing I'd say is he runs the floor. The first time I noticed it was in the Big Ten Tournament. I was watching, and not necessarily even scouting Maryland, but I was just watching the Big Ten Tournament. I couldn't believe how fast he ran the floor and how athletic he was. He's obviously bigger than our posts, which is going to provide a problem for us, and we're gonna have to work hard to limit his catches and try to keep him away from the basket if we can. But he's also very quick. He has very good feet. If he feels pressure, he'll go away from it. He'll spin, and so he's going to be a big challenge for us, no question, inside.
Scott, I mean, a lot of talk, obviously, about Mike versus Diamond in that matchup down low, but some pressure on some of your other guys, whether it's Reed or Ian or some other guys, to step in with rebounding and defending in the post?
There's pressure on everybody. I would say that, you know, physically, we don't match up to them. They're much bigger than us, really, at every position. If you look at the starters or who we're bringing in the game, and so everything we do is going to have to be what we call gang mentality, whether it's rebounding, defensively. Like, we can't guard Melo Trimble one-on-one, particularly in all the ball screen stuff that they do. The whole team has to get involved with it. So it's just going to have to be a gang mentality for us. The rebounding in particular is going to have to be on the defensive end. We can't give them a bunch of extra shots.
Jim Allen, Spokesman Review, Spokane. Coach, talk about the tempo of this game and what you're trying to achieve on the court in terms of tempo.
You know, I think that really both teams play at a similar tempo. In other words, we're not going to try to control the pace and slow it down, and I don't think that they do either. I think that we're both fairly free offensively in terms of what we allow our players to do. And so I don't expect, you know, a game in the 40s and 50s because I don't think they want to play that way, and we don't really want to play that way either.
Coach, we've talked before about your backcourt with Parks and Marshall. Maryland brings a equally dominant backcourt. Can you talk about that matchup and what are you guys looking to exploit on your end in terms of the guard play?
Yeah, I'm not sure if there's much we can exploit. You know, what I look at is how are we going to guard them? And again, they have the size advantage. They probably have the athletic advantage too, although, you know, Deondre and George are fairly athletic kids. What has to happen, though, is our entire team has to get involved in plays, whether it's ball screens, handoffs, because they just do a lot of stuff that create mismatches and get you in what we call a two-man game on one side of the floor. And if you help at all, they're both of those guys, when you look at Suleiman and Trimble, they're both very good passers. And if you help at all with your big guys, you know, you're allowing one of their big guys to roll. Most of the time they're rolling right at the basket, and it's hard to get involved. And so we have to have the guys on the outside of the floor. They have to do a very good job of making sure their feet are touching the paint so that we have all five guys involved.
Scott, your guards didn't shoot well in the Summit League tournament. If they are able to do that, would that take some pressure off the rest of your guys and make it easier on you?
Well, Yeah, when you say didn't shoot well, George shot 15% in three games, and we won, which I think, number one, speaks to our team, the toughness, the defense, the things that are important to us. Because, number one, if we're going to have a chance to beat Maryland, we have to be great defensively. We have to rebound the ball at a high level. It won't matter what we do offensively if we don't do those things. And then, yeah, we're gonna have to shoot the ball much better. And I think that, you know, our guys know that. They've been in the gym quite a bit. We've had obviously a lot of time off, and so I think they've had some free time to get in there and get a good rhythm. And really, it's not just our guards. Even our bigs are gonna have to shoot the ball well from the perimeter. It's one of these games where it's gonna be very difficult for us to score at the basket.
More questions for Coach? All right. Thank you, Coach.